Hi folks, this is David Kwan here, and this is another negative video where I kind of rant about Final Fantasy XIII-2. So, a couple of my videos on this game, I was just like, wow, this is such a great game, I really enjoyed it, this is, you know, one of my favorite RPGs that I played on the PS3, I think I've said something like that, and I agree with that, but there are very annoying things about this game. In the previous video, I talked about the level design of Academia, which just goes beyond me how annoying that level is, that map design is. But another thing that's super annoying gameplay wise about this game are the puzzle levels. There are these weird side quests where you go in limbo, you know, you enter this alternate world where like time and space is totally different. You're in like a weird limbo area. I forgot the jargon that the game uses. But you're there, and there's three types of puzzles that you have to do. The two types of puzzles are quite easy, at least initially. In the later parts of the game, they get super, super difficult. Like, so challenging. Almost unfairly challenging, but yeah. And then one puzzle, which is like a clock. Oh my god. Anyway, I'm going to talk about that last. But there's two types of puzzles. One is like connect the dots. So you're on these tiles, and there's like a constellation picture. This picture is shown, and you have to connect the stones by walking to the tiles and stones. You have to connect two at a time. So connect the green colored stone with another green colored stone. And when you do that, the color of the stone changes to whatever, white color or red color. And you should connect whatever color it changes, you should match that color with another stone. So that way you draw this constellation picture, which is fine. You know, this is like super easy, some of the state, like in the beginning stages. Now, later on, this puzzle gets really challenging. Because the colors of the stones sometimes randomly change, and you have very limited amount of time, like 30 seconds or 40 seconds, to connect all the stones as fast as you can, and you can't jump over tiles that are designed, whatever. So I didn't feel like that frustrated by this. You know, it's kind of tedious to have to repeat. It's not fun. But whatever, I guess this is there. You know, I'm not too mad or upset about this. I'm just annoyed by it. The second type, I actually really like this one. It's super challenging, but I liked it. You know, this is the kind of thing that's like, oh, this is really cool. This is one where if you walk on the tile will kind of shake and it'll fall. And you have to like plan your move around the tiles so that you could get to the end goal. With keeping in mind, if you touch this tile, it's gonna fall, you can't go back. And some tiles you can use twice, so there's that. Some tiles are permanent, so they don't fall, you can use that. And so that was really cool, and you have to collect all the little crystals or whatever on the path to unlock the exit. I like that one a lot, and by the midway point, oh man, they can get super, super challenging. And I tried to beat them all without looking at the guide. I think I did. I did look at the guide for one of them, because it was just like I kept dying and dying and dying and dying. I was like, how do I do this one? I don't understand. You know, because it gets a little bit crazy because some of the crystals that you have to collect teleport. You know, and it's like, what? So you have to time it perfectly. So that was crazy. But I actually like those ones. The final type of puzzles. And they're actually, I would say these are like super puzzles. Oh my god. The clock one. This one required me. No, seriously. I had to get a pencil and a notebook paper. And I like scribbled all over the place just for these types of puzzles. Beginning ones are not that bad. They're like, you could, it's so easy. But the other ones, Like, it's insane. And they're all... The guide, when I looked at the guide to how to do this one, the answer is, yeah, sorry, we can't really help you. These numbers that you're going to get on these puzzles are randomly generated. Shit. So there are some websites out there that you can go that has this complicated algorithm operating in place to help you figure out what to do. But it's a complicated process to do the algorithms. So it's like, good luck, you guys. Shit, like what? So there's this clock, and each there is a number on each spot. You know, the most complicated one will have 13 numbers or something like that. And each number is 3 or 4, and there's a clock. If you click on the 3, then the clock will move 3 spaces. Or if it's 4, it will move 4 spaces. And once you hit that, the number disappears, but you have to make sure that the clocks all touch at one point. Like they can't both touch empty spaces. Otherwise, that's failure, and you have to restart it. But it should always touch at least one number. So by the end, all the numbers are empty, and you'll have whatever. It's a very mathematical thing. I don't know the algorithms, but I was like, some of them are timed, which is the most ridiculous thing. So sometimes I did this. I looked at it, I hit pause, I got out my notepad, I wrote all the numbers down in a circle, and I was like, okay, so if I pick this one first, then this one's going to disappear, it's going to move. I had to like calculate it onto my paper, it was just like so much jotting and down. It was ridiculous. I was like, am I playing a game or am I doing a math assignment? Doesn't make sense to me. But that was some of the most challenging puzzles ever in a video game. What the heck happened? This is like I was taking a math class and I was failing horribly because it was taking me so long. There are sets of side quests. One side quest had me do 5 at a time, 5 in a row. And I was just like, I finished the third one and I was just like, alright, yay, I finished the third one. That was the most challenging thing ever. I thought I was done, but nope, another clock. I was like, seriously? The fourth one? But yeah, the puzzles, they're optional, you know, so, some are required, actually, for completing the story. But most are optional. Some of the optional ones, like in Aerba 200AF and Aerba 300AF, I want to say, like, those maps are just those side quests, just those puzzles. The one that related to Moogle going back to his home. Oh, that was a struggle. That was like, at that point I was like, I'm not playing a game. I am doing schoolwork. The worst kind of schoolwork. Because I hate math. And that's what I had to do. Just to get 100% on this game, man. Getting a platinum trophy for this game, I'm telling you, you have to have a lot of patience. Extreme amount of patience. But yeah, those are the three kinds of puzzle side quests that are in this game. And the clock puzzle, like, that's seriously a puzzle that's going to require a pencil and paper. Or find a website that calculates the numbers based on an algorithm. I haven't used one, but I hear they're out there. So good luck searching for one, because otherwise you have to do the math, and that is quite an endeavor. If you guys enjoyed, I think I could do one more video about Final Fantasy XIII-2, and hopefully that'd be it, because I know I talked about this game quite a bit by this point.